Hi guys, and welcome to another video. Today we'll be painting an easy landscape, sorry, seascape painting. And I think we'll finish in about 1.5 hours. Yeah, this is very like a beginner type of painting. And if you just want to chill, you know, don't stress too much about details and don't stress too much about a lot of subjects in one painting, then this painting is for you. Okay, let's begin now. I'll just introduce first the colors that we'll be using today. First, we have the phthalo blue, black, what's this color? This is bright aqua green, this one, oxide green, sap green, lemon yellow, burnt sienna, titanium white, and maize yellow. So again, we'll start with the sky by using phthalo blue. Tiny bit of white, just tiny bit, just to make the colors or the color opaque. Thank you. Okay, while it's still wet, we're going to gray this side a bit and lighten the middle part. How to gray the color? We're just gonna add some white and a little bit of black. White, black, and then spread it here. I think more white. This is just to suggest some dark clouds forming in the sky. Okay, white and black. And blend. I'm gonna go in the middle. It's the same mixture, but more white and blue. And a little bit of blending here. Then mix with white. We're just gonna start right away with the clouds. While the sky is still wet, I mean while the paint is still wet, not the sky. We're painting the sky, but sky is not, it's not wet. I hope I am making sense. I think that's too much. Just use your fingers. I will write in the description box all the colors that I'm using, because I think one commented that she was having a hard time understanding my accent. I don't know what's wrong with my accent, but I think I'm just anyway, for the benefit, for her benefit and for the benefit of those who experience the same, then I'm just gonna write in the description the colors that I'm using. Okay, just mix white and more blues this time. And dry your brush a bit, it's kind of wet. So we're gonna dry brush like that. And again guys, control your brush, not the other way around. I like it. Okay, this time we really don't have to wash our brush out completely, like, or it doesn't have to be perfectly clean. Just remove most of the water or most of the paint from the brush. We're gonna use the same brush, but this time we'll be using Aqua Green. Aqua Green mixed with blue. That's why you really don't have to wash the brush completely or perfectly. Just have more emerald Aqua Green in your paintbrush. And then yeah, just follow what I'm doing. I'm gonna use emerald green for the water. Okay, this is the first layer. Emerald green plus blue. This is an easy, I categorize this painting under easy level. Okay, sorry. Okay, I'm going to mix more more aqua green plus tiny amount of blue. I think more amount of blue this time. Okay, and then water it down. Actually guys, I'm not using any microphone when I speak. So if you have, if you get confused, because you really did not understand what I was saying, just comment in the comment section below and I'll answer them. And next time I'll be using a microphone. or if my accent is giving you a hard time, just tell me. Okay, just use Aqua Green plus white, and we're gonna paste that in here, like somewhere in the middle. Like that. And here as well. Somewhere near the horizon. Oops. Sorry. We're gonna change brush. We need a brush that is more defining or with pointed tip. We're gonna use some black, a little bit of black, and then blue. Then water. Then draw a straight line. To define our horizon. Again, guys, if you're not into drawing straight lines, you can use tape as suggested by other teachers, but although I mentioned it, I will not really recommend doing that kind of convenience, because I really want my viewers to learn how to draw a straight line. Now, if you ask me how to draw a straight line, just don't think about it. Just don't think too much when you do it. Just like that. Just start where your horizon should start, and then move as quickly as possible. That's the technique. Because if you go really slow, let's say like this, really slow like that, you know, the tendency is for you to lose that concentration in drawing a straight line. To me, that's just my technique. Now, if you can draw a straight line by doing it really, really slow, then it's up to you. It's just my technique. The quicker my hands are, the more steady the straight line is. Anyway, we're going to use the remaining blues near the shoreline here. And then again, I'll be using my fingers just to blend it. And then we're going back to it later. Also here's just to suggest some blue lines. Okay, now we're going to the sand part. We'll be using a cleaner brush because we don't want any other colors to get in touch with our sand. So we're going to use Maize Yellow, and we're going to paint straight away. here. Maize Yellow. And we're not gonna wash a brush. We're going straight to white while the maize yellow is still wet. Well, the very purpose of the maize yellow, you know, you may be asking, why is she painting white over it when she just painted it maize yellow? Well, the maize yellow is my underpainting. To be honest, before I really was not into doing some underpainting. Before, when I was just starting to paint, or when I was just learning how to paint, I really didn't appreciate the importance of underpainting. I was like, why don't you just paint straight away? Because underpainting for me before was a waste of time. But now I see the importance of it. I mean, it can be dispensed with, you know. There's no hard and fast rule about how to start your painting. You may or may not underpaint, but now I see the not the importance, but how the underpainting makes a huge difference compared to a painting that was not underpainted. Okay. Then we need more white because we just ran out. White. And then pure white, titanium white here. This is just pure titanium white over maize yellow. So I'm confident that the maize yellow is still not dry underneath. So it's still showing and I kind of like it. Hey, nice. Okay, we're going to use the remaining white in detailing, no, in giving details to our waters. So just mix white with aqua green. And then paint near the horizon. Again, fingers. Actually, I like it. Nice. I like it. There's a hint of yellow. I really like it. Okay. And then aqua green again, just to blend. Whoops, sorry. Because the sand is really dry, it's really wet. I'm actually touching it. Blue. Then more blue. Okay, but water down here. The sand. Darker blues. Nice. Oh, you like it. Okay. Right, now you can wash your brush out Then I'm going to use thinner brush, and we're going to use some burnt sienna black. More black. Water. Black. I'm going to start with the trunk. The sand part in the painting is still wet, but I think I can already paint over it. Yeah, I think so. Just be careful not to smear. I can actually feel it. Yeah, see that? It's still wet, but it's alright. Because, yeah, I think it's fine. Just mix black, burnt sienna. Doesn't matter. Okay, the most exciting part. I'm just gonna use a pointed brush. Actually, this brush, if you can see, look at that. The shape was caused by my overuse and abuse of the paintbrush. It's not about it's not the actual or the initial look of the brush there's no brush like this for this brand. It's just that because of overuse, you know, it's gotten really worn out. So mix black with sap green. And then just follow my brush strokes to create natural palm leaves. Yeah. real sap green and black, okay? Sap green and black. Be random, guys. Be random, because again, I keep on saying this, nature is random. If it follows a particular pattern, like buildings and structures, it doesn't look natural at all. And we don't want that when we're painting nature. Random. Sea waves, it's random. Leaves, movements, they're random. They cannot be forming a diamond or something like that, unless, you know, a flock of birds are flying. Of course, they form some kind of shape, but in general, nature is just random. I think that what makes nature really beautiful. I kind of like it. I think I like this more than the first time I did it. Okay. We're going to use the same brush, but this time we're going to do the highlights. So wash your brush out. And then use burnt sienna, and then yellow, burnt sienna, black, and then we're going to do some brown. Like that. And then yellow. Yellow with white, I mean. Then go back to yellow with brown, or burnt sienna. Then now we go to Oxide Green mixed with black, just to mute the color. Oxide Green plus Yellow and Sap Green. Burnt Sienna. With white. For any highlights here. In black with Sap Green. Black and Sap. To it later. I'm going to change brush. Tiny one just for the details. We're going to use Maize Yellow plus white. Plus white. Tiny bit of black. To mute it. Okay. Watered it down because I'm having a hard time spreading it. And it's a little confusing. Because we're not yet done, that's why. Okay. Next. going to use white, but you have to be very in control of this. Going to use black. I'm not washing my brush because I don't want it to be super black. Okay. Like the shape of this, swing, or I think they say this is called a hammock. Is that right? The shape reminds me of here. Just color this black. And then here as well. Nice. Going to do some grays here. Fix this part if it's kind of weird. It's like like that. Like it. We're almost done. This is an easy tutorial, as I promised. We're going to use some grays by using black and maize yellow, white, and then black. Okay. I think this is too dark, so we're just gonna add white. All right, let's go. So, let's add the shadow here. And then, here as well. And then, we're gonna add some black to it because we're, this side. Trust me, this is gonna work. We're almost done. I think we'll be done in like 15-20 minutes more. And then we're going to add some shadow here. Okay, and get some pure black. Some grays here. Okay. Like that. Almost done. Okay. Okay. This is nice. Really simple and nice. Okay, we're going back to the sand again. This time we're going to add more white, pure white to this part. Like, add white randomly. Do not add white evenly. That's the trick. Or that's the tip. Okay. Let us wait for this to dry because I need to do something to it. Add some pure white. Add pure white here. Here as well. Here as well. So it's like a white sand. Okay. then we're going to do some random white or some little waves hitting the shore. Some foamy waves hitting the shore. So just add or paint some white lines, random white lines near the shoreline. Just paint over some white. This over. Some burnt sienna and then white and black and more black. To create realistic details of palm tree trunk. Love it. Love it already. We need some pure white. It's dirty. Pure white here. back to the tree. To the sky, I mean. Let's just use white here. Here as well, but not too much. Like that. Okay. I saw something, I think. Okay, I'm going to use our blues. Like pure blue, but watered down, because we need to darken this area. So here, okay, nice, really nice. Okay. We need to get our this maize yellow and just like randomly apply it here. I'm just using my fan brush. You can actually use any other brush, it's not required. It's just that it's my dry brush here, so you don't need to buy a fan brush. You know, just to follow this step, you can use any brush. Okay. Like that. And then use the same brush for white. Random white. Near the near the point where the water and the sand meet. We're almost done. Like it. Okay. Like that. Okay. Okay, this part you don't have to to do it, but I want to do it. So just get your palette knife, get some white. I've never done this, I never did this when I painted this for the first time, but now I think I need, I think I can already, because I'm confident that this will result beautifully. I'm using palette knife to highlight the tree trunk. Actually, it's really nice. I like it. Okay. What else? Okay, I think I'm just gonna highlight. Get some white and just get some highlights. Like that. Highlights just pure white. Actually nice. And get some black. And get some yellow and a little bit of brown. Nice. Okay. Okay. Just one more thing. Just fix it because our horizon is kind of crooked. Just use Phthalo Blue. To straighten that horizon. Okay, nice. get some pure yellow. Pure yellow. Pure yellow with white. Pure yellow with white. Here. Okay, I think this part is already dry, so just like this, just glaze something over it. Kind of like it. It's like that. It's right. I like it. You can use some gray just to give a little more definition. That we keep on doing it and then erasing it, but that's the trick actually. Okay. Fix this swing or hammock. Okay. Right. These two. Okay, now we're going to sign it here. But then, you know, sometimes you just see something again. Okay. think we're done. We're done. Thank you.